believe when you do that with their best defender, that's what Kellyanne is, no question about it. She runs over interviewers all the time. And she does it with cleverness, she does it with information, she does it with tactics, and she can also do it with personal invective when it suits her. She used all of them on me tonight. But it exposes the reality that they cannot explain away the lies of this president. Maybe it's criminal, maybe it isn't. Maybe it matters, the Mueller probe to the presidency, maybe it doesn't. But the lying has to matter. Yeah. And I lay it out, example after example of what it is. And I keep her on task about it the best I can. And to the extent that she varies, to the extent that she redirects, it's all evidence of what they want to avoid. And I think it's instructive to the American people.
Okay. And you know I don't want to beat you up, right? Because this is,
yes,
this
you
is
do.
What we talk
about.
No, I don't want to
I know
beat
you
up.
Don't think she should be on TV. I don't believe in silencing the other side.
It's not silencing the other side. It is not a right for someone to come on CNN and lie and deflect. This was a defective,
people do it all the time,
dismissive and histrionic display of non-answers.
But people
at
do
a time,
that all the time.
Please. At a time when the American people need to be reassured that we are in good hands, when all of the evidence shows that the president is lying to the American people, what Kellyanne Conway does and what the apologists do, they, how do I say this nicely? I don't want to be rude. They take up your time, our time, on national television when we could be learning something that's important to us.
Yeah, but Don, come on. Let's be honest about what the program is. You have a bunch of voices on every night. You think people learn?
This is not, hang on, this is not about left. People think this is about ideology. If Kellyanne Conway wanted to come on and the apologists want to come on and they want to talk to you about policy, I think that's a completely different thing. But what they're coming on to do is distract you, distract the American people. Chris, I learned nothing from that. She told me nothing about the
I think you learned
she
that
learned
they
nothing
don't have
about,
good answers to
she
these
learned,
questions.
We learned nothing about why the president lied. We learned maybe that, that she had no
they
answer.
They don't
that,
have
that she
any answer for any of them.
And then she comes on, and instead of answers, she wants to hit you, which really ticks me
I
off.
I think
because,
that shows something
because
too.
Because you're allowing her to come on, you're giving her a platform, which is a privilege, okay? So, and I think that that's great. Okay. So, I think you're allowing her to come on. But then she doesn't respect you or the platform. She hits you personally. She
but
hits CNN personally.
Her,
and none of it's true at all.
But
I would rather have someone come on who can explain to the American people with a sense of reality and based in some sort of fact and reality about what's going on. Sorry, go on.
No. Listen, I hear what you're saying. I hear it all the time. My pushback is, you know, to the left, nobody's acceptable. They don't want anybody from the right on.
True.
A senator,
absolutely.
Congressman, any
absolutely.
Pundit, anybody. They don't even want the president on. I don't believe any of them. I don't want them on. I don't believe in that. I think you got to keep an open mind. I think you hone your own arguments by hearing the other side. And I'll tell you something, that this is the best they have to put out for the president of the United States. It tells you a lot. Insulting me, that is like, to me, that is like ice cream. Because it proves you've run out of insights and arguments. All you've got is cheap shots. And I think it reveals something to people. And I think it's an important part of the dialogue. Now look, do I wish it could be different and more constructive? Sure, that's why I have a Robert Ray on as well. You know, I have other people on. I'm not gonna close off the other side though, Don. And if that's who they wanna put out, that's who the people
get. Because you keep saying it's the other side. That's what and maybe for you, you feel that way. This is not about the other side. People who are conservative have brains. They understand what's right and what's wrong. They understand facts from alternative facts.
I know, but a lot of people believe what she
believes.
That's
not ideology. A lot of people, listen, honestly, a lot of people believe in the whole Kool-Aid thing, if you know what I'm talking about. And
right, but a lot of people
believe
that the president wasn't lying. Look, you just have Robert Ray here saying you don't know for sure. That guy's a genius, you know, and he's a real rock-rib conservative.
Okay,
so you've got to have the conversation.
If I told you the president wasn't lying about knowing about payments, and then you show me a video of you on your show, when you first started the show, right, breaking the news and playing the recording of the president talking to Michael Cohen about payments.
Right.
Okay, so he's not lying? That's not a lie?
Right. So then they say, okay, so you heard that he had knowledge of it, but what he said was He didn't know anything about the actual payment. The actual payment isn't discussed.
He said
we never heard him direct Michael Cohen. See, so there's nuance, and you've got to attack that part.
He said he didn't know about it. He said he didn't know about it.
I understand.
And then he said, talk to my attorney. If someone came on to, here's the thing. If someone said, well, we're going to have a debate about whether cigarettes cause cancer, you would say, why do we need a debate about that?
True.
Okay, so then why do we need a debate about what
facts
are?
It took us years to get there, Don. It took us years to get there in a huge trial. It took us years to get there in a huge trial.
But my question is, would you waste your time with people who come on to argue the other, to argue that cigarettes don't cause cancer?
I don't think we have that kind of consensus in this country on these fundamental questions about the president's been asking.
On a video, you played the video.
I know, but it leaves room.
Or the audio.
It leaves room. Yeah, the audio with their voices. People get it. But look, all I'm saying is, I hear you, and I respect the thing. It's why I don't do panels on the show. I don't want a panoply of heads giving me their opinions on things. I want people who are players, and I want to test them. That's what Cuomo Primetime's all about. That's the only reason I left the morning. I didn't come here, you know, to do more of what I was doing in the morning. So I get it. I get it. I'm saying that's their best. She is their best on this. That's why they sent her out to come after me. And I want the American people to see what the president considers his best defense. And they saw it.
Okay, so then what do you think they got?
I think they saw that she has a hard time justifying what the president has said. That she tries to use cleverness in place of certainly concision, but also having real arguments and real facts. They're not on her side. And that if you test this White House, you immediately become a target of it. And that's really important for people to see. You cannot watch an interview like that. You'll say, I interrupt. I interrupt everybody. But I'm interrupting for a reason. I'm never personal. I'm never insulted.
Mm-hmm.
I always stick to what I know and what I can show.
But she was. I know you guys know each other.
And that's
but
another
I think, but she was, but she is, it gets personal to her because she doesn't have an answer she wants to
that's
distract.
The point.
And that's
and
how she distracts
get
you.
To see it. And I'll tell you what will happen. On the radio show tomorrow, when I'm walking the dogs, when I'm on the, people are going to say, boy, she really came at you. You know, you really kept your cool because she wasn't making good points. You know, that's the point of the interview. If she makes good points, she makes good points. If she, you know, and sometimes she does. Sometimes she finds space and gaps that we don't know and she can expose it. She's very smart. But often she doesn't. And I think that that's what tonight was about. Did I let it go too long? I always do.
I don't know how long it went.
I'm into it. You know, once I'm into it, I want people to experience that. If they don't want to watch, they don't watch. You know, I went down to Tijuana because I thought it was right. I knew people weren't going to watch. They didn't watch.
Well,
I get that. But sometimes
different.
I put things on because I think it's important.
Yeah.
And this is the best the president has. If you're out there and you support the president, if you're out there and you're a conservative or you're open-minded on it, you're not sure, you just saw what their best case is, and you show what happened when I tested it, I got attacked. And it's important for people. Is it completely satisfying to you? Nope. I get it, and plenty of people agree with you.
Okay. We could go on.
I don't want to eat up too much of your show.
We'll do it. Excuse me.
We'll do it this weekend. Hopefully I see you.
We'll do it this weekend. I just got to say, you have more patience than I do. Thank you, Chris.
I love you, Don. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right, you too, buddy. I'll see you later. This is CNN Tonight.